Take six. This is the sixth take of this video. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my channel. My name is Joachim Lucius. I'm the founder of Ghost Pictures Production, based here in Antwerp. Today I want to talk to you about two hidden features that I just found out on the Canon C200. Okay, well, actually I found out one a while ago. I didn't find out myself, actually, to be honest. I watched a video from a fellow YouTuber who owns the Canon C200, and he revealed this, and which I was really happy about. And the second feature, I'm really happy that I found it out myself. It means I'm really getting to know my system properly. So without no further blabbing, I'm just gonna go straight into these features. The first one is actually object tracking. So it's not surprising to know that a lot of Canon C200 owners don't know that this system has this feature. And I must tell you, it's really fantastic. It's really helpful. It's really good. It's efficient. I mean, it's Canon. The autofocus on this camera is amazing. How you want to find this out is, you want to go into your assignable buttons, this settings, and you want to just assign this function. It's called tracking. You want to assign it to one of your many customizable buttons on the C200. I know this is not easy to find because it's not openly on the menu settings, or neither is it does it come with a custom button of its own, so you might not know about this, and that is how to find it. It's really good, especially when you combine it with your face only or face priority system function. It does a fantastic job at tracking your object, tracking your face, tracking your teeth, your nose, something, your eyes, something. It does a really good job at doing that. Guys, I'm sorry, I just woke up. The second reveal is the auto white balance lock. I didn't know this system had that function. Coming from the X3 and X4 system that has this function, I always wish that I could do this, because I think the conventional or traditional way that we all use the auto white balance on the C200 is we use the auto white balance, we see the readings it gives to us, and then we navigate to the custom settings, and then we dial in these readings we got from the auto white balance system. This works, it's efficient, it's good, but it's not really time saving. Having found this out today, I'm happy to reveal that you can also find this this function in the assignable function settings, and just like the tracking as well. So all you need to do is navigate to where you see auto white balance lock, assign this function to one of your many 12 assignable buttons, I think on the C200, and next time when you set the auto white balance, all you need to do is you press this lock button, and that's it. Like, it's as simple as that. There's no magic, no further magic, just that. All right, guys, so that was it. Thank you for listening to me to this point, and I hope I was able to help you in one way or the other. If you like my content and if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and you know the cliche thing every YouTuber says, press that bell button to activate my notifications, so that when I make a new video, you'll be the first person. If you care about that, if you care about being the first person to see my video, so you'll be the first person, hopefully. And if you don't care about it, you just know that, okay, yeah, this dude has uploaded a new video, and hopefully, yeah, it helps you. And until next time, I'll be wishing you a good morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are in this part of the world. Hopefully, if you're still in planet Earth, if you're not in Pluto or somewhere or any other place, do have a nice time, and please stay safe, keep creating, and that was it. Yeah, you can go now. I'm done, really. I'm done. You can go. Okay, you wouldn't go. Okay, then I'll leave then. Bye.